Good morning. I'm Judith Richard. I'm the broker owner of Perfect Choice Properties here in Concord.
And I'm Carol Jordan, branch manager here in Concord, New Hampshire for Fairway Independent Mortgage Company.
I've asked Carol to join me this morning to discuss some financing on FHA foreclosures, also known as HUD homes. These homes are owned by Housing and Urban Development. And I think most everyone that knows me knows I do a lot of these listings. So I wanted to get with Carol today, and we're going to do a discussion on some of those acronyms. And she's going to help me out by explaining them to you. So Carol, IN, meaning insurable. Tell us what that means in the lending world.
Well, FHA will insure a loan as long as it meets the HUD guidelines. So an IN property means that it's ready to be sold with a straight FHA loan, or it could be a conventional loan, or it could be a VA loan, that home meets all of the HUD guidelines and it's insurable by FHA.
Terrific. How about IE, insurable with escrow?
Well, that means that the property, although it's insurable, has some minor, could be a mechanical rehab, but under $5,000 that can be addressed through an escrow process of taking at least 1.5 times of the actual repair. So if it were a $1,000 repair, it would then be a $1,500 escrow that would be set aside to have the rehab done after closing.
Awesome. Okay, so the other one that I run into all the time is UI, which that's uninsurable. So explain to us what that means.
Well, that means that the home has most likely under $31,000 worth of rehab that needs to be done to bring the product or the property up to insurable standards with HUD. So you would have a contractor go out and give you an estimate on what it is that needs to be repaired to bring it up to HUD standards. You would go through the process and then close on the home, and that escrow money would actually be added onto the loan, and then you would complete the rehab after you closed.
So this brings us to what HUD or FHA financing world would call a 203K?
Correct. 203K is a section of the Housing Act that talks about how to rehab a property to HUD guidelines.
Okay. And are there two of them? There's a limited, and I think there's another term, but I've always used the term big K.
And that is what we call it, the
okay.
big K.
Okay.
And it is anything that is when a property has a rehab that's over $35,000 or is structural.
Okay.
Or would require more than 3 contractors.
Oh, interesting.
And that becomes a very complicated process. You need a fee consultant, you need the appraiser, you need a contractor. There's a lot of moving parts with that product.
Okay. So if I was going to do the big K, or somebody wanted to do a big K, is it true that as long as I have a foundation, I can take everything down to that foundation and start building over?
That is accurate, all the way up to the county limits for FHA in the county in which the property is located.
Okay, so I bought a house at $100,000, and I want to take it right down to the footprint or the basement walls or whatever you want to call them. Pretty sure I can put up the rest of it, what I want to do with it, for about another $100,000. So I'm all in, say, $200,000 to $225,000. How am I with the big K, the big 203K?
That would fit into any limit within New Hampshire in any county. You would be good. If you were in Hillsborough County or Rockingham County, you would be much higher than you would be in Merrimack County. But $200,000, you would be able to do anything in the state of New Hampshire, no matter which county.
Okay, so that's interesting and very good to know. I'm also thinking that what happens if I wanted to go to about $300,000? I think I'm fairly safe in all of the counties.
Yes, you are. But once you start reaching past that $300,000, you're going to have to look at what county you're in and work very closely with your lender. Because, you know, one town or another right on the line could make all the difference.
But if I use, say, a 290 benchmark, I'm probably safe in all the counties?
In all the counties. Yes, ma'am.
Wonderful. That clears up a lot. I got to tell you, Carol, I so appreciate you coming in today and discussing this with me. And hopefully we're going to be able to get this out to other people to kind of understand what goes on in the financing world when you're buying a foreclosure from HUD.
I thank you for having me.